Ladies and gentlemen, this match is one fall. Introducing from the dark side, Randy Rose. Ladies and gentlemen, entering the ring area from Kansas City, Missouri, Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Right now, he's in the top five of the World Heavyweight Championship rankings. Hacksaw Butch Reed has, as we have mentioned in recent weeks, has really been on a tear here in the NWA. The fans in Chicago and Milwaukee, Baltimore, Denver, Colorado, Reno, Nevada, out in the West Coast in California, wherever it may be, that they have the opportunity to see this man. He has one thing on his mind, and that is become the world's heavyweight champion. And whatever he has to do, or whomever he has to go through to do it, it's what he's going to do. He misses with a big soup on right, and Randy Rose with a nice move there, getting underneath Hacksaw Reed, taking him down with the arm drag. And Reed complaining that his tights were pulled. There you see him. He's not working for Don King or Don Cornelius. Looks like he might be working at some restaurant. I don't know. It's a nice outfit. But Teddy Long, Theodore R. Long, and we have seen in recent weeks that savage, that deranged human being, Norman, who he says didn't do it.
You know, Mr. Ross, I was over at ringside, and I just happened to think I would like to send Ric Flair some flowers. But on the other hand, I'm unemployed. I'm out of a job. So if you get time, would you send Ric Flair some flowers and charge him to Mr. Flair's room? I'd appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah, what a jerk, I'll tell you. Send him some flowers. Well, big move there by Randy Rose. Lateral press, and Reed kicks out very quickly, and he's up quicker. Send Ric Flair some flowers. Well, Ric Flair has gotten thousands of flowers and thousands upon thousands of cards. And the fans, I think, the fans of the NWA are so knowledgeable. Whether you've agreed with Flair's tactics over the years or not, I think all wrestling fans respect his ability immensely. And what Terry Funk did, I want to tell you, it's not going to go unanswered. And we'll be speaking with Ric Flair's doctor and know more about his situation and when they expect him back in action. Next week right here on this broadcast. Teddy Long, I'm unemployed. He's not dressed like he's unemployed. He must have connections somewhere. And I've seen him around Hacksaw Butch Reed on many occasions in the last few weeks. Nice move by Randy Rose. Holding on to Reed. Randy Rose, a very tenacious veteran here in the NWA. With the arm bar, and it's a massive arm he's got barred there of Hacksaw Butch Reed. Still to come, fans, we're going to show you exactly what happened in the first round of the World Tag Title Tournament. Boy, Rose just went right out on the floor. For the Road Warriors and the Freebirds, that's coming up next. Reed stomps away at Randy Rose here on the outside of the ring. Gosh, right on the steps. Reed is on a mission right now. He wants to wrestle any top 10 challenger. He doesn't care. Whomever it may be, including the number one contender, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. As we have mentioned, Joe Pedicino will have that updated top 10 in this hour on Joe Pedicino Knows. Reed pulls Rose back in right over the top rope. Rose's arm is hurt right now. Reed really taking this man apart. Reed knows the big money is being the world champion. Misses with the elbow. And Randy Rose now street fighting with a hacksaw. Going downstairs with the right hand. Sends it for the ride. Rose follows it with a football tackle right into the corner. Another Irish whip. He's got to be careful here. All the way out to the post. Reed is cat quick. Rowe's shoulder really hurting now. And Reed trying to take advantage up top. Big football tackle turns Rowe's a 360 there. And Hacksaw Butch Reed with another victory.
Winner of the match, Hacksaw Butch Reed.
There you see Reed, 260 pounds. That missile coming right off the top rope. Number five contender for the World's Heavyweight Championship. Looking to take on any of the top contenders, including the Dragon, the number one contender. And here's the man to tell you all about it. Here's Joe Pedicino.
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again this week to Joe Pedicino Knows right here on Worldwide Wrestling. Already an impressive showing by the Samoan SWAT team on today's show. Still to come, a handicap match, that World Tag Team Tournament update, and our main event. And in just a few seconds, I'm going to be talking to you about why my sources in Charlotte say it may be time for Ric Flair to hang up his boots. But right now, let's take a look at the top 10 contenders for Ric Flair's title. This is the official NWA top 10. Coming in at number 10 this week, it's Kevin Sullivan. Number 9, Ron Simmons. 8 is Dick Murdoch. Bob Orton comes in at number 7. 6, the Great Muta. Butch Reed fills number 5. Lex Luger, number 4. Sting is 3. Hayes comes in number 2 with the U.S. title. And Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the number 1 contender. Those are the official top 10 contenders to Ric Flair's title. Now, those contenders may not have anyone to go after. Why? Because privately I have found out from my sources in Charlotte, North Carolina, that the doctor that is taking care of Ric Flair's neck and back injuries has sat down with Rick and his family in private and has suggested that the time may be here for Ric Flair to retire. The back injuries are more severe than we thought. The neck injury, quite a bit more severe. And the doctor is telling Ric Flair he might want to retire. It's because of the tremendous pile driver on the table in Nashville. It is time for Ric Flair. Next week, a report from the doctor, and we'll hear it directly from him. Wrestling fans, that's just a sample of the action you'll see when the Great American Bash comes to New Haven, Connecticut and the Coliseum. It's a triple crown, two-ring King of the Hill Battle Royal with $25,000 going to the winner, plus a fan will be involved in that match also. You will see a top contenders match, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat taking on Lex Luger. It's a grudge match when Sting faces Terry Funk. A tag team challenge will happen when the Road Warriors try to get revenge against the Samoan SWAT team. It's a Dragon Shy match. Eddie Gilbert steps forward to take on the Great Muta. A Battle of the Bulls takes place when Dr. Death Steve Williams faces Terry Gordy. A special challenge match will find Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express taking on Butch Reed and Ron Simmons. You'll see the Steiner Brothers against the Fabulous Freebirds. Norman the Lunatic will be there. The Dynamic Dudes, Flying Brian, Scott Hall, Danny Spivey, Bob Orton, Ricky Santana, they'll all be in New Haven, Connecticut in the Coliseum for the Great American Bash. Make your plans to be there Friday, June 23rd. Don't forget the autograph party at 7. The action starts at 8. It's the Great American Bash on tour.